I greet all our Christcake families in the beautiful, loving name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What a privilege tonight to preach the gospel again and still having the time and freedom to do so. We are forever grateful and so thankful to God. You know, Psalms 150 says, everything that they have breath must praise the Lord. So I believe we're in great debt. We're in great debt. We're in debt for our praises, because God says everything that they have breath must praise the Lord. This is a time, especially now, that we can praise the Lord. That's the purpose of breath. God gave us breath of life to serve and to live out the purposes of God and to live out and to praise Him. That's what David got the secret, that with our breath we have to praise the Lord. And how many times are we, God giving us breath, and we don't praise God with every breath that we have, but that's what we should do, and that's why we're in great depth tonight in praising God. And that's why coronavirus came in this time, to take away your breath. The devil don't want you to praise God in this end time, because of what God is going to do in this end time. He's going to pour out His glory, and you know, on all flesh, and people will worship and praise God, and different revivals will break out. But we are living in a time where the devil knows that, and the Bible even says in Revelation 12 that the devil knows his time is short, and he's trying everything within his power to stop the breath, to stop your breath. And that's why coronavirus come in this end time, especially a time where you should praise the Lord. So I believe this is a good time and moment and opportunity for you that still have breath to praise the Lord and to worship Him, because we are in great depth of our praises. We are in depth with God, and we have to praise Him, praise the name of the Lord. And we know the word corona means crown, and we don't want to crown corona, we want to crown our Lord Jesus Christ. And we see the power of corona. There's power in coronavirus. It closed down basically everything. But I can tell you one thing, it cannot stop the name of the Lord Jesus. And that's why it's so powerful to know His name and to move under that name and to understand the authority that's in that name. And we are really forever grateful. You know, in the Bible, Hezekiah, the prophet came and tell Hezekiah that his time is short, his time is over on earth. And you know what Hezekiah did? He went to God and he said, the death cannot praise you. And you know, God added 15 years to his life. God actually added 15 years of breath to Hezekiah, just because he catched the revelation of David, that actually says that everything in their breath must praise the Lord. And just because he said the dead cannot praise the Lord, you know, if you can say that wherever you're in the hospital, wherever you are on a sick bed, and it looks like you're not going to make it, you know, make this vow that Hezekiah made and said, listen, Lord, the dead cannot praise you. I want to praise you. And God will add, I believe, more years of breath to your life to give God praise as He did with Hezekiah. You know, this is also a time where we can see in the Bible, Enoch said he's going to walk with God. When he saw death coming closer, and death was a step away, as 1 Samuel says, death was a step away, and Enoch said, I will walk with God. And he never went to hospital. He never ended up in a morgue. He never ended up in a graveyard, or you know, he ended up in heaven because he was walking with God. So this is really a time where death is so close to walk with God. It's the best thing to do at this time, is to walk with God in this hour and season of death. And I want to tell you, that's why David came in Psalms 23, and David said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You know, with this coronavirus, it's basically a shadow of death. And we don't have to fear anything. What you should do in this time is to have faith in God. And what you also need in this time, more than tablets, more than hospitals, more than doctors, more than a breathing or oxygen machine or anything, you need the Lord to be your shepherd. That's what David said, because David had experiences. He experienced the shadow of death, where death was so close to him, he thought he was going to die. But David wrote this and he said, listen, the Lord is my shepherd. And I want to tell you, when it comes to death, especially this coronavirus time, it's a season of death, like the Bible describes it, a season where plagues and pandemics will come that will produce death. It's a good time to make God your shepherd in this time. And we have to go to work, we have to go to the mall. You cannot always stay in the house, and you cannot be ruled by fear. And that's why David said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You know why? Because the Lord is your shepherd. And that's why you should not fear. You should walk and know the Lord as your shepherd as you go to work or go to the mall. If you have to go out, don't walk in fear, but walk in faith. And that's how important it is. And we see in the last book in the Bible, especially where the pandemics come, Revelation is a book that speaks about the end time and pandemics and plagues. And you know, John was put on that island and he saw these visions, and it was basically an island of death. It was his death sentence. And this last generation, we are basically in our death sentence with this coronavirus. All these different places that will come, first wave, second wave, different waves will come, different pandemics will come. We're in the season of pandemics, and I'm telling you, season of death. And you know, on that island of Patmos, when John basically experienced death many times, you know, why he survived was because the Lord appeared to John on that season or in the time of his death, where death was so close to him, and Jesus appeared and Jesus showed him the keys of death. You know, God have authority, Jesus have authority over death. He overcame death, hell, and the grave. And that's why you should know the one that you serve have the keys of death. And he is the one that have authority over death. And I'm so excited God gave the keys of life to Peter, and he said, you know, to the church, I'll give you the keys of heaven, of the kingdom. And but in this end time, I believe there's a time where God is going to give in this end time the keys of death, where people will believe and have faith, and they will overcome death in many ways. You know, pray people, resurrect people, pray people out of the morgues and out of even out of the graves. And I believe this is going to happen because Jesus in this end time will give the church the authority over death. Even where Apostle Paul said, you know, death, where is your sting? Where is your victory? And death, he spoke to death as if death was a person, because death is a person, and life is also a person, and life is Jesus Christ. He's that tree of life that was in the beginning, and death, that tree that of good knowledge and evil, knowledge of good and evil, and that produced death was actually the devil, you know. And that's why in this end time, this is what God want to do. So I encourage you to praise God, worship God with your breath that you still have in your lungs, and also to tell the Lord, you know, that as Hezekiah said, Lord, the dead cannot praise you. And like Psalms 150, David says, everything in the breath must praise the Lord. So in this time, with that little breath that you have in your lungs, why don't you start praising God, receive Him as your Lord and Savior, and just start worshiping God. So I have a quick short word here. The Lord spoke to us here and there about this, and I want to continue on this, and I want to bless our Grace Cake family also with the scripture. It's right there in Revelation chapter 14. Revelation chapter 14. I'm just going to read verse 6. I want you to read verse 6 till verse 9 at home, but I'm only going to read verse 6. It says as follows, Revelation 14 from verse 6. It says, "And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on the earth, to every nation and kindred and tongue and people." I want you to see another angel, because John has seen a few angels, and I want to go into that, and I want to show you what actually happened there. So may God richly, richly bless His word. And I want to title this sermon, Angel Flying with the Gospel in the Lockdown. Angel Flying with the Gospel in the Lockdown. And you can see, you can put people in lockdown, but you cannot put angels in lockdown. You can put earth in lockdown, but you cannot put heaven in lockdown. And you can stop people, and you can stop preachers, and you can even stop the church of Jesus Christ with a pandemic and a lockdown, but you cannot stop heaven. You cannot stop the angels of God. And right here, God basically saw that there's going to be a lockdown in the future, and a lockdown especially in this time. And God commanded angels to fly with this gospel. And that's why I'm so thankful to know that although the churches are shut down, although pastors are limited to preach the word of God, and we cannot gather together, that God has sent flying angels. And right now, as we are speaking right now, where there's no church, we cannot actually preach in our churches, we cannot have services or revival services or anything, I'm telling you, there's angels flying around. Right now, angels are flying around with this gospel according to this word. In this lockdown, this is what God is doing. So you can put earth in a lockdown, but you cannot put heaven in a lockdown. You can put preachers and people in a lockdown, but I'm telling you, heaven is not in a lockdown. The angels of God is not in a lockdown. You cannot put the Holy Ghost in a lockdown. You cannot put the anointing of God in lockdown. You cannot put the power of God in lockdown. I'm telling you, earth is in a lockdown, but heaven is operating. Heaven is moving. There's no limitations. There's no lockdown for heaven. The angels of God is moving. And that's why you should be happy and excited, because the Bible says, as it is in heaven, so shall it be on the earth. So right now, the supernatural is moving. The angels of God is moving. The power of God is moving. And there's no limitations, praise God. So you can be limited. So right now, you don't have to go to the house of the Lord. God can send His angels to you, but heaven cannot be stopped. And this gospel cannot be hindered. And that's how powerful it is. Right now, at this moment, you cannot stop healing, you cannot stop deliverances. It doesn't mean when there's a lockdown and the church is in a lockdown and pastors and preachers is in a lockdown, it doesn't mean that the anointing is not working. The anointing is in a lockdown. The power of God, revival or healing or deliverance, whatever you need, I'm telling you right now, the angels of God is moving quicker and faster. And that's why they're flying, they're moving so fast. Amen. They're all over. Heaven is not in a lockdown. God is not in a lockdown. His spirit is moving. Deliverance is still available. It's still, the power of God is still available. But right now, God wants to meet you in your house with your family, as it was in the days of Noah, as it was in the days of Sodom. You know, God's angels came to a family. And that's what God wanted to do in this time. As Joshua said, me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And it's so amazing, because in the book of Exodus, the father had to apply the token, the blood. And in that blood was the angel of the Lord. And that's why the dead angel couldn't come in, because the angels of life that preserves life, the angels of healing, the angels of protection was there. And that's what we need in this plague time, as in the book of Exodus. You know, and that's why right now your pastor can maybe not come to you, a preacher cannot come to you, maybe nobody can lay hands on you, or there's no services. But I'm telling you, heaven is operating. Heaven is operating like never before. It cannot be stopped. You cannot stop this gospel. I'm telling you right now, angels are flying to even to hospitals. Angels right now. Maybe the preacher cannot go to the hospital. Maybe the pastor cannot go to the hospital. Maybe the pastor cannot come to your house and do house visits or preach the word of God or even lay hands on you. Or maybe your pastor cannot go to you in the jail. But let me tell you, the angels of God right now, they are flying to the hospitals. They are flying to the jails, cells. They are flying all over. They are going from house to house, because according to this scripture, in this lockdown time, God said, thy angels are still moving. Are you not excited about that? To know while the church is in a lockdown, the pastor and the preachers is in a lockdown, that the angels of God is flying around with the word of God. You cannot stop this gospel. It's still moving, and we are so excited to know that. And it's amazing. The only church that was in a lockdown, according to God's word prophetically, is the seventh church. It's in the book of Revelation, the book of Laodicea. When Jesus came to that church, the door was closed, and he had to knock on the door. You know why? Because that Laodicea represented a time of earthquakes. It was a city of earthquakes and plagues, and God knew that that represented how the age that we are living in, the seventh church age, the age where there's pandemics and where the church will be in lockdown. So that's the only church that had a lockdown, basically. And it was in a lockdown because of pandemics and plagues. But right there, the Bible says in Revelation 4, and there was an open door in heaven. And John was invited from the earth to heaven. And right now, God is not inviting you to go to church. God is not inviting you to go to a prayer meeting. God is not inviting you to go to a revival service in this pandemic hour. God is not inviting you to go to a special preacher, to a special church. But God is inviting you to come to the throne room of God to receive messages. God's heaven's doors is open. Angels is all over. You can see open visions, open dreams. The portals of heaven are open all over the earth. And angels are flying up and down, ascending, descending as Jacob saw it in Genesis chapter 28. And I'm telling you, it's an amazing time. This is the most powerful time, where you cannot hinder God, you cannot stop God, and you can still believe God. You don't need a preacher, you don't need church services. So God right there, he knew that Laodicean age will be a pandemic age, an age where the church doors will be closed. But at that same time, John said the heaven's doors were open, and John was invited to heaven. He wasn't invited to a prayer meeting or revival conference or anything, but he was invited. And right now, God is inviting every believer to the throne of God. He's inviting you to heaven. He's inviting you for his healing to flow, his power to flow, his provision to flow. He's inviting you. The power of God cannot be stopped. It cannot be limited. God is still moving. And I'm telling you, this church, its doors are locked, but heaven's doors are open. You can put a church, it's in a lockdown, but you cannot put heaven's doors in a lockdown. So God is saying that the heaven's doors are open. Healing is flowing. Deliverance is flowing. God is still moving. But in that Laodicea, that city was in a lockdown. That church was in a lockdown, but not heaven was in a lockdown. So we are so excited to know that, and to know that you can put a church in a lockdown, but at the same time, heaven was not in a lockdown. In Revelation 14, God knew. That's why you see a flying angel. Why? God, you see a flying angel because a change happened there. He said, I saw another angel, and there was three angels coming, if you read at home. So a change basically happened here. Another set of angels came in, and I'm excited to tell you that God is sending another set of angels. God is sending angels that's flying. There's speed to the gospel. There's no limitations while you're in lockdown. I mean, the Holy Ghost wants to move. God wants to move. His presence wants to move like never before. Where churches was in limitations, churches, people couldn't attend all the revival services. If there was a revival service or a tent service in whatever city, there was limitations. But right now, there's no limitations. These angels are flying all over. At the same time, they are flying from city to city, country to country. The Bible says, and they are going with the gospel from nations will hear it, and kindred and tongues, for nations, kindred and tongues to hear it. So there's no limitations. You don't even need money to spend to go to a conference or revival service. God says, I'm sending my angels for revival for you. I'm sending my angels for healing. You don't even have to go to a man of God right now to see if you're healing. nothing. God is saying, I'm sending my angels to your house. So brother, I want to say, right in the end time, in the days of Noah and days of Sodom, there's angels coming. And the Lord told me, you know, this is a time of where angels will come. Entertain the angels. Open your door for the angels of God. Angels is about to come to your house. Angels is about to visit your house. And I'm telling you, you can be in the lockdown and angels can come to your house. And right here, angels are flying. They are in a, they are on a mission. This is another set of angels, because John saw angels in churches. He saw angels in house services. He saw different sets of angels, angels in politics, angels that's in hospitals, angels that work in different places, different areas. But right here, he saw a specific group of angels that are flying with the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I'm telling you, they are moving, and a change is happening here. Normally, God sent an angel with a message to go down to earth. Oh my God. But right now, God is sending angels with a message to fly with the gospel. Oh, that's powerful. And right there in Matthew 24, we also see it. So in Revelation 14, we see in a pandemic time, the angels are flying with the gospel. And we see in Matthew 24, it's also a pandemic time. Matthew 24:7, the pestilence is a pandemic time. He says, but in Matthew 24, the gospel will be preached. So we see these angels involved in Matthew, in Revelation 14, in a pandemic time. Also in Revelation 24, they are involved in a pandemic time. And right there in Revelation 14, and you can, although it's a pandemic, in Matthew 24, you can see these angels moving out and taking the gospel. Praise the name of the Lord. So right now, these angels are moving to jails. They are moving to hospitals. Although men of God cannot go there, pastors cannot go there, maybe because of the lockdown. But we can see this gospel will be preached. Nobody, a pandemic cannot stop this gospel. God is sending flying angels. Matthew 24 also tells us this gospel will be preached. And gospel is good news. It's not only bad news that's coming. We will hear of resurrections. We will not only hear of death. We will hear of resurrections. We will not only hear bad news. We will hear good news. We will not only hear that business is closed down. We will hear breakthrough for business. We're going to hear supernatural stories. In the time of this pandemic, we will see angels operating, and the gospel will go out. Good news will go out. Breakthrough will happen. Provision, creative powers, you will see it all. Praise God. And right there, the gospel will be preached. The pandemic cannot hinder it. Right in the book of Exodus, we saw 10 pandemics. Right there in the 10 pandemics, you know, Moses preached the gospel. Oh my God. Maybe people were worried about the pandemic. The whole country talked about pandemic, but Moses had the good news. He had the gospel. He had the Exodus message. He says, "We are coming out. We're not going to die. We are coming out. Praise God, and we will break through. Amen. And this gospel will be preached in this pandemic and in this lockdown. It will be preached to nations and tongues. How will that happen? Because every nation is in a lockdown. Every city is in lockdown. How can the gospel be preached from nation to nation, country to country, to kindreds and tongues, and there's a lockdown? You cannot fly to another country to preach the gospel. You cannot go to another city to preach the gospel. You cannot travel. There's limitations right now because of the pandemic. But what is God saying here? How and why is he sending flying angels? Because of these lockdowns. And these angels can go. And I believe this is basically satellite TV. That's how God's going to preach the gospel. So every preacher, even a farm preacher, can become an international preacher because of these angels, because of media platforms, because of Christian and satellite TV. God is putting and promoting every preacher. I'm telling you, he's promoting you. You feel maybe down and out. There's no church. There's nothing. But I'm telling you, God is promoting your ministry, and he's taking you to higher ministry. These angels are there to open platforms, to open dimensions for you, and to make provision for you. They are involved in creating and giving opportunities to Christian television so that this gospel will be preached. And God is not a man that he should lie. God is a God of his word, and he's going to make provision. And in this time of shaking, I don't know if you know, but heaven is shaking, earth is shaking, earthquakes, tsunamis all over. Things are falling from the sky. Asteroids, meteors are falling from the skies, from heaven, because God said, I'll take heaven and earth, and I'll make provision. The silver and the gold is mine. God is in control of the stock market. God is in control of business. God is in control of everything. There's equal opportunities, and God is creating opportunities for the church so that this gospel can be preached. And I'm going to tell every businessman to build the house of God, and not to build your company, not to build anything. Nothing. You cannot invest your money in nothing no more, because there's no value, because the shaking is happening, and God is in control of the stock market. He's in control of everything. And that's why you can invest in God. We invest in Christ's cake. Invest in these gospel channels that can help take out the gospel. And the Bible says, and then the end will come. So we can see this Christian television broadcast, Matthew 24, is also a quick message. Matthew 24, things will happen fast, because Matthew 25 is the coming of the Lord, which is a twinkling of an eye. But we can see in Matthew 24, There's earthquakes, there's all these things happening, so it's a quick time. God cannot send a letter, God cannot send a book, God is sending satellite TV. Metro 24 is Media 24, and Metro 24 is 24-hour news channels. How will you hear of earthquakes and rumors of wars? You will hear through satellite TV. And Metro 24 is also, and right there in Metro 24 with those news channels, and everything, he puts right there in Metro 24, he puts the gospel will be preached. In other words, amen, Christian television. So there's going to be news stations 24/7, but there will be Christian television stations 24/7. So right there in Revelation 14, we see angels flying, that satellite TV. We see right in the pandemic, Matthew 24, that satellite TV. We can also see the flying angels in Revelation 14, Matthew 24. We see in Exodus that Moses was a prophet. He saw visions from God. That is Christian televisions, angels giving him visions, God coming down, angels giving him visions and dreams. So that was Christian television. That was God speaking through him in a vision, was actually TV. TV was invented by God before men, even at the revelation of it. God breakthrough through dimensions. God created dimensions so that God can speak from heaven to earth. And we are so excited. So Moses was an eagle because he said, I'll take you out on the wings of an eagle. How did God take them out? He took them out with a prophet. And a prophet is an eagle in the Bible. And a prophet sees visions. God said, I'll speak face to face with a prophet. And that's amazing because he saw the television station with visions. God showed him. So it was angels giving visions. And that's what God's angels are going to do in this end time. That's why I said, in the end time, I'll pour out my spirit. Young men will see visions. They will dream dreams. It's angels flying with this message in the end time. So right there in the book of Exodus, in Revelation 6 verse 7 and 8, we see the fourth horse, which is pandemic. And then we also see the fourth living creature, which is a flying eagle. The Bible calls it Revelation 5. The fourth living creature is a flying eagle. So we see the flying eagle, and that's also dimensions, because an eagle flying in a dimension. We see television, Christian television there again. So I wanna finish off with this, that I want you to tune into Christian television, tune into Angel TV, tune into Eagle TV, tune into Christian television. Take your phone, tune in with your phone. Get your phone tuned into Christian media platforms. Get your laptop tuned in, not a specific church, but to any church that have the Holy Ghost and Spirit, with that they have thus say the Lord, that you can feel the anointing and the power of God. Tune your laptop into Christian television stations. Tune your TV into where angels can speak and where eagles, prophetic messages can come through. And that's what I want to tell you, God. And you cannot go on TV unless you have airtime. And that's why God in Genesis, God is the one that gives airtime. He gives breath of life. In Genesis 2, he created Adam and he blew the breath of life. He gave Adam airtime to speak. He gave Abram airtime to speak. He gave Ezekiel, Moses, all these men airtime to speak. He gave the church in Acts chapter 2. So Genesis chapter 2, God gave Adam airtime to speak. In Acts chapter 2, he gave the church airtime to speak. And right here in Revelations 22:17, in this final showdown, last days, Revelations chapter 22, verse 17, he says, the Spirit and the bride say, come. So God will give the bride airtime to speak. God will give you airtime on your phone, on your media station, on Facebook, on whatsoever platform you're going to speak. Christian television, whatever platform, international platforms, God is the one that gives you airtime to speak. So I will say, tune into this time. Don't be discouraged about sitting at home. There's no church, there's no services. It's time to serve God, as Joshua said, me and my house, as Noah said, build the ark. In the days of Sodom, angels came to the house. And open your door, open your TV, open your laptop, open your phone to Christian television, where angels have messages, where there's eagles coming with prophetic messages. And may God richly, richly bless you. Tune into this, and there's flying angels while you are in a lockdown. Heaven is not in a lockdown. The power of God, anointing God and his angels, is not in a lockdown. God bless you. We are praying for you, each and every one of you. God richly bless you till next time.
Saggies vroeg, hoor ek haar voetstappe in die gang, op pad na haar alleen plek, waar sy met Jesus praat. Op my bed, in my kamer, te hoor ek dit weer. Sy noem my naam voor Jesus. Keer op keer. Dankie, lieve moeder, vir my naam in jou gelief. gebeen. Jesus het geantwoord, hy hoor nog gebeen. Dankie, liewe Jesus, vir my moeders gebeen. Die antwoord nog gebeen. Losbandig in my sonde, totaal vastgevang op my bed, in my kamer, toe hoor ek dit weer. Jesus, wat met my praat, keer op keer. Dankie, lieve moeder, vir my naam in jou gebed. Jesus het geantwoord, hy hoor nog gebed. Dankie, lieve Jesus, vir my moeders gebed. Die antwoord nog gebed. Noem my naam voor Jesus. Keer.